making some of our audibles or line communications. We'll have to see, but I thought they did a great job of blitzing us the second half.
Coach, what made it so hard for you guys to stop Winicky or Goddard today?
Well, they're elite players, for starters, and we were probably on the field a little bit more than we probably wanted it to be for our liking. Wish we'd been able to control the ball a little bit more. So, you know, sooner or later, they're going to make enough plays, and let's credit Christian. I thought he did a phenomenal job of moving the chains with his feet, and those two guys they're dynamite players, and I thought we battled them for four quarters.
Coach, was there anything unexpected or surprising about their running game?
No, other than they hadn't run Christian as much. You know, I knew he had the ability. They just hadn't done that. And give them credit. They did a nice job of designing some runs for them.
Last offensive series, what was said in the huddle before you guys went out? Hey, I'm guessing that was your chance to.
Hey, 4-minute drive. You bet. 4-minute drive. That's what we wanted, is to have a 4-minute drive, get a couple first downs, and kind of kill the clock, and we didn't do it.
Any injuries to speak of?
I think Bruce probably re-injured his ankle, so we'll have to check that out. But he was the only one that I know of.
Defense keep coming up with fourth down stops time after time. I don't know if you felt like you were on borrowed time there or what, but it was just one.
Absolutely. You know, they just kept finding ways to make plays. Trey Dempsey made an unbelievable play in the back of the end zone on an interception, and no question that we were hoping to get something going to at least, because I think we got tired at the end. There's no question about that, but that's not an excuse. We need to be ready to go, and just didn't happen today.
How much did that first drive for them kind of set the tone and said this is going to be a time of possession kind of game where you alluded to it, they were on the field a ton of that first drive?
Well, yeah, and then we flipped it and went 99 yards in 9 minutes or whatever the heck it was, and so not very many games do you see where there's two possessions and the first quarter's over with, and it was kind of like that the whole first half, and I told the guys at halftime possessions would be a premium, and we had to do a great job of making the most of our possessions and then limiting those guys, but it's a good football team. And I think we're a pretty good team too.
You talked a little about Christian, but he looked outstanding today, just running around, making plays, making throws.
Absolutely, he did a great job. And he's just a sophomore like Easton, and he's a good football player, and he makes them go. There's no question about that.
SDSU has some big playmakers, but it seemed like your team did a good job of preventing the home run.
Well, we talked a lot about the explosive play, and we couldn't allow that to happen. And our secondary grew up a lot today. I thought they played really well, and a couple of plays that they made, but I thought they played really well against, we held them to, I don't know what it was, 19 points. That's pretty doggone good, but wasn't good enough today, and that's where I want to make sure that our guys know, and they do. I don't care if we win 52-51 or 6-3. The bottom line is getting the W, and it's a team win and a team loss. And this was a team loss, and we'll move forward.
Players hear streaks, 8 in a row, 6 in a row, and you hear all that stuff.
We never hear that, Jeff, and that's a good point. We don't ever talk about it. There's social media out there, so I know that it is set out there, but we don't ever talk about that. We talk about going 1-0 for the week, and our guys are going to be hurting for 24 hours, and then we'll come back and get ready for the next one.
The decision to let Chase lead you guys out of the locker room before the game a long time ago, was that made with the team?
I just did it myself for the last minute. I love the kids so much. I love the family. I know what tough time they've been through. I know how important it was to his dad that he played today, and it was my small way of honoring one of the finest young men there is in America.
Chris, how do you go forward from here? You mentioned not letting the same team beat you twice. What do you address the guys here when you see them again on Monday?
Well, by that time, we'll look at the tape, make some corrections, and we'll move on to Western Illinois, because let's be honest, we're 5-1. We still have a pretty doggone good football team, and we've got to go back to work.
Thanks, Coach.